It's all working. Live and everything. So, hello. Welcome back to Joyless Gaming and Hitman 2. There's a elusive target. It's on Sapienza, so that really makes me think it's a reactivated one, but it's not really ringing any bells. But, I mean, it's a thing to do, so I'm going to do it. Although I think we've already had a reactivated Sapienza elusive target. Or two, I don't know. But, you know, it's something different. Break up the monotony.
Welcome to Sapienza 47. We have two targets for you. Congressman Anthony L. Trout, a veteran of the invasion of Grenada, and Richard J. McGee. Though at first glance these two might not seem connected, they have a long-standing collaboration manipulating Trout's political opposition. Trout sends McGee after his weak but potentially dangerous adversaries and lets McGee manipulate and ultimately break them. Trout and McGee are in Sapienza on an arcane meet and greet with European moneymen and power brokers ahead of a possible presidential bid in 2024. We know that Trout is staying at the Via Caruso in the town square, but McGee's business is much more clandestine, and we don't have a location for where he will be. All we know is that he is to meet a Keith Keeble, a rich young man, and possibly their next victim. Time to show them the consequences of political manipulation. Good luck, 47.
Right, is this a new old one? Because these were separate targets, weren't they? This guy, I remember. Yeah, this guy is the one that's always touring around the mansion, right? And you can get him under the mansion when he's testing wine or something, but that guy was from something else as well, wasn't he? So these were two separate ones that they've now put them both into the same thing. I think that's it, because I remember this Trout guy. And he's around the villa. And this guy I think I do remember, and he's somewhere in the town hall or something. If they just put them into one thing. Of course, demonstrate that I've already done something here. Okay. Do I even really need a lockpick? Maybe, maybe not. Smuggle in a lethal poison. Not sure if there's a lethal poison you can find on Sapiens, or if there is, I've forgotten. Yeah. I could swear that having watched the thing and it mentioning them that they were previous elusive targets, but they've somehow bundled them together. Well, I say somehow, but obviously just a bit of work and stuff they've already designed they can make into a new thing.
Good afternoon,
by bundling them together.
Trout and McGee have arrived in Sapienza. We know Trout is at the Via Caruso, but you'll have to find out where McGee will be making contact with Mr. Keeble. Security is unusually high, especially with Caruso in residence. Do be careful, 47.
Gotta load the map in. Don't need that. Chief lethal poison. Now, Oh, thought I would need a lockpick for that. This gives me largely free rein to wander around. Yeah, there's that guy. So he does try that one.
Very good balance. Long and thin. My compliments to Mr. Caruso.
Thank you for your input, Congressman. I am sure Mr. Caruso will appreciate it. Shall we proceed?
The problem is,
it'd be good, man.
You get a lot of people that are in view of it that will take issue with you poisoning it. Dark down here. Right, now, where are their security consoles? Oh, there's one across the street in the thing. Fairly certain I remember there not being a way to poison that without being seen.
Yeah.
show yourself.
Did I? Oh no, there it is. Yeah, they both see right through that. Half of mine to look for an emetic poison. And then drown him in the toilet. I'm sure I can find an emetic poison around here. Kitchen somewhere, I'm sure. Yeah, there's one in the kitchen, isn't there? Really wish 47 could turn off taps. Because now that I've failed to distract somebody with that, but I've got a different plan going. Oh, is this tourist? No, that's not him. There's no hat. Ah, there he is. Oh, wait a minute, if I could get rid of his other bodyguard, I could push him off there. Oh no, there's a staff member. Who is that? Remember her? If he can get rid of his other bodyguard, well, if he can get rid of both of his bodyguards, and you can drop a, can you drop a chandelier on him or something there as well? All of these things you could do. All these opportunities. Yeah, maybe not a chandelier, but you might be able to explode the fireplace. Although I'm not sure where you explode that fireplace. I think it can be done. Why? Oh, he's following him in there. He's following his guide. It was his guide who went to clean it up. But if he's going to go back and drink again, he should come into this bathroom. Then I still have to go and look into the other guy, but that's the thing of combining two pre-existing elusive targets that were not designed to actually work together. It does make them a different kind of challenge, doesn't it? Because, you know, they could come into conflict with each other or have things that don't allow you to just do what you would normally do. Because, of course, I won't be able to save. Oh, I forgot to pick up the... It's a cellar. Yeah, it seems a little cool. It's a wine cellar.
It's a constant 11 degrees and 75% humidity.
Uncultured swine. He is going to have another drink, right? I hope there's not a... Good, doesn't look like there's a bin in here. When they have this terrible habit, when there's a bin in the bathroom. When there's a bin in the bathroom, they'll go and throw up in the bin rather than in the toilet. Okay. And I can afford for his body to be found because it'll be an accident, so this guy I'm pretty sure is over here somewhere. I forget the best way to deal with him though. No, that's that woman's anomaly. Normally, yeah. Yeah, there's a whole thing going on upstairs. Sure if I'm allowed in that building or not. Oh, that's okay. Crucially, I haven't been recorded by a security camera doing anything illegal. I think I'm going to want to get one of those security outfits, though. Down there somewhere in the office. Alright, I lost my thing. Oh, just wasn't showing up in Hitman Vision. This guy is out there for a while. He's not. He's going to come back in before I thought I would get the coin over the other side, but... Alright. Patrolling guard. Wait a minute, that was mansion security. I already had a mansion security outfit. Bloody hell. Patrol. So I wonder if I could lure him away with the gun. That'd be an idea, wouldn't it? Drop the gun somewhere he can see it. see where he goes with it. You know, another thing I could do, I should pop back over to the mansion and grab a bodyguard outfit. Maybe I should investigate that, although I don't know if the bodyguard is technically allowed up here. I'm gonna go do that. Bodyguards I knocked unconscious is in a box.
How you been?
I'm not entirely certain if the outfit is it's technically trespassing. Why were they even allowed to wander around? They won't be trespassing out in the open, because basically no outfits are supposed to be marked as trespassing out in the open. I'm starting to remember some things about this, where I think you can set it up so you can drop the chandelier on him in the office. But I think it's the same one that had a caveat about not killing, like, the boy that's supposed to be there with him. The target, one, the target's target. See, now it's the bodyguard is the one who's, okay, this is not trespassing. That is, okay. Just can't win, eh? I forget how you set it up, but I do remember bits about this, and I think I did. By the time this was reactivated for the first season, I didn't care about Silent Assassin anymore. Hostile area is not a good thing. Right, I for some reason thought that there would be a thing. Why did I think there would be a thing? No, because I have this feeling that if I go into that... Bloody hell. Should have done this first. I need to deal with this guy. This guy is causing me problems. Now. Okay. Part of my problem is that this room is full of enforcers. Absolutely full of enforcers. And I need to deal with these guys. I deal with these guys, that guy's not a problem. Then I just need to deal with the target. I'm surprised nobody's gone into that bathroom to find the sake, 47, you sack of shit. Can't knock him out until you're up his ass. Is that it? You can't fucking swing this thing in front of you far enough to actually connect with something that is not... something that isn't close enough to be considered part of your own fucking molecules or something. What the hell? Got fucking spotted by somebody who should have been unconscious by then. Forty-seven, you suck. Well, I've been compromised twice because of your fucking stupid inability to clobber somebody standing right in front of you. Say, you have to fucking form molecular bonds before you can fucking hit the guy. Okay, now I've got a bit more wiggle room. Is that the target below me? Or are they both wearing hats?
Hey, Mr. Bodyguard.
Hello. That's in there, isn't it? That's my target. Guy in the hat. Get a better view of him, but I can't. Oh well. Surely he should come back upstairs at some point. Unless I just fucked up by knocking out that guy down there. Which was sort of an accident, but how much can I claim that it was actually an accident when I had to go through the process of pressing the button? Is that even the target? Or the other target? We got rid of everyone who was... in my way... down here. Pick up something? What? Town Hall key. I'm gonna confirm if this is my target. It is my target. And I think perhaps he's bugged out because I did something. Very distinctive outfit. Come on, I'd much rather use an elegant solution. Ah, there we go.
Well, no offense, but your breath smells like a rat crawled up your ass and died.
That's some pretty horrible breath. Alright, well, maybe he shall at the very least resume standard functions. I could poison him, though. Otherwise, I'd like to drop a chandelier on him. Unless he does sort of get stuck here and I can get him to stand, then I can poison his drink and he'll sit back down and die. Which I think shall be my solution. Wait a minute, what the... No, I was about to say, isn't that one of those twins that the other elusive targets, but...
Yeah. Hell yeah.
That'd be a way to really fuck you up. You know, all those season one elusive targets that happened on the same location. Let's make them all active at the same time. No. Yes. Pretty sure I can poison stuff in the kitchen assistant outfit. And the only enforcer is in the kitchen, so. To sit back down and trust that I wasn't tampering with your drink just then. Please do actually drink. Yes, thank you.
Mission completed. Time to find a place.
There's normally an exit here, because they disabled it. Oh well. And get 47's clothes. Be silent assassin because I got spotted by two people that 47 refused to hit in the head when I told them to. But otherwise, should be a 4-star. Rating at least. Bodies weren't found, I'm pretty sure. Well, the first target wasn't even found at all. Would have been an accident, so it wouldn't have counted, but. Still. The guy never even went to check on him. Some bodyguard. Guy disappears into the toilet for half an hour after he was talking about. Yeah, 4 stars. Oh, okay. Signature suit with gloves. Thanks to, what was that, Elusive Targets 3. Which was, what, like 10 or something of them. So yeah, that was actually 2 Season 1 Elusive Targets that they bundled into 1 active mission. Huh. If they're going to do that, and you're going to recycle some Season 1 elusive targets, can you recycle ones on different maps so that we can unlock different suits, please? I think there's only been... where is it? Yeah, it is in inventory. Suits. Okay, they did one on Paris. Sapienza and Hokkaido. Yeah. Paris one was the Black Hat, and did they do another one? I think they might have done another one as well. And they previously did the, what is it called? The Prince? That Cardinal or whatever that you have to assassinate. And I think they may have done another one before that. I can't quite recall. And they did the Fugitive one on Hokkaido. I feel like they've done another one there as well. Did they redo the Surgeon's one as well? I'm sure. But they still haven't done one in Mumbai or Whittleton Creek for season two. Because I think the only one they've had on Florida was actually The Undying, and that repeated. So, yeah, signature super gloves. Okay. What is it? Will it be mastery or challenges? Yeah. Yes, didn't do Silent Assassin on there. But I don't need Silent Assassins. Or The Undying Returns, I didn't get Silent Assassin on that. I did get on the first one. Prince, Black Hat. I didn't get Silent Assassin. That's right, I got kind of fucked over that one because I... Politician. Oh yeah, that was the one that was Hawke's Bay. And yet, no reward. There was nothing for that. They didn't have like a wetsuit variant or anything like that. The Fugitive. The Appraiser. That was the one that was on Isle of Scale. That was the one in Columbia. Undying. First Undying, anyway. Yeah, there was no reward for the Hawke's Bay elusive target. So 3 was 9 targets. 2 was 6 targets. There doesn't appear to be anything more than the 5 Silent Assassin elusive targets. But that's the exact same rewards it was in Season 1, the Terminus suit and the Winter suit. So 12 and 15 elusive targets. 12, you get the Undying suit. Casual undercover. Not to mention suits for all of the different locations. Well, I mean, that was interesting, but also kind of, meh. What's this? I don't even play ghost mode. Alright, well, I mean, that took probably longer than it should have, but... Even though I started later, I probably should do something else. What else is there to do? I've done all of that. I did that last week. How about I do these escalations? Pardon me. Do these escalations so they stop showing up. Because they keep showing up. But I have redone the training mission stuff. Why am I sneaking? I'm allowed out here. Which one's the clear bit? That one.
Thank you.
I think I failed to pick up a crowbar, because I seem to remember doing this with a crowbar. Because it was a while ago that I did it. That is the... Soviet soldier, Soviet soldier. Yep. I seem to recall there being an opportunity to poison something, but is that just... Do I have to get into his safe before I can do that? I think I do. Yeah. Okay. Okay, that worked. Yeah, just the one exit on this map. Safe and steal the contents. Do I have a lockpick? Not. Crowbar? No, there it is. I knew I remembered there being a crowbar. M47.
Told you it was a
Alright, so you just need to be fast enough. This is not at all alarming. It's all just standing with a suppressed pistol in their hand. And that guy just leaves whenever that guy leaves as well, so. Never mind the big pool of blood.
You know that guy who flew in from last down the boat?
Right now, protocol.
Frankly, I'm surprised they haven't got all of the Season 1 escalations working. The Season 1 locations are working, but the escalations that are available are not all of the ones that were available in the first season. Okay, different target, but I can still do this guy first. I don't even need the rifle. Oh! I have to be disguised as a mechanic to kill that guy. But that's okay, I can basically do the same thing, wait for him to walk out. Kill him and dump his body in the thing. I there was that contract that somebody made for this level that had like 4 accident kills. I don't think I was ever actually able to do that one. The pistol is the center of gravity. Pretty sure I can get a mechanic disguise over the other side. Okay.
Yeah, I snuck a piece of shit.
We might just do that. Those are military secrets.
Bunch of projected slides, travel route or something.
I think there's one in here somewhere. Think.
Back home, it's Cuba. You got tons of rum and vodka.
Yep.
Military airfield.
I know, but at least protect them. That man is KGB. Pretty high up in the chain. That.
Okay. Is there not a way down? Oh.
You know that guy who flew in from Moscow?
Oh. Elusive.
That KGB officer?
Yeah.
Oh well. Could've taken one of my victims' outfits. There's a disguise on the way out, but hide dead bodies within 90 seconds. Well, I pretty much already did that, so. Okay.
And on.
What I could do is I could do the mechanic thing first, because that other guy is still a Soviet soldier. Probably shouldn't mess with the winning formula, but give it a go. This is why, because it's actually a better opportunity to kill that guy first, because he just walks in here. Because I don't think he's going to leave again before that guy gets here. But I can wear his clothes. That's a Soviet soldier.
Crude but devious.
Yeah. Amateurs to be untrained eyes. Yeah, that's why I do it that way. Because it's better that way. I can just run off and get the mechanic disguise. Oh well, this will make it take a bit longer. I suppose part of the problem is that, wait a minute, what? Yeah, the guy's still, yeah, that guy's still there. Well, eliminate him with a pistol. I could just... just sort of leave him here and shoot him and then dump his body in the box. Yeah, that'll work. Alright, bear that in mind for next time, that I can get away with that. Need to wait for this guy to leave. Can't get away with it, but it's faster to go about it the other way, kind of. Because I can kill him, dump him in there, run over and get this outfit, and get back by the next time that they will be leaving. So it'll give me something to do in the intervening minutes. Also worked.
You know that guy who flew in from Moscow?
Oh, he's the real one. You pronounce the more problem.
also worked and it took about the same amount of time, really, didn't it? So, yeah. So unless there's another strange complication, I may as well do it that way. Pacify anyone you'll fail a mission. Okay, there we go. There's the complication that disallows me from doing that. Pacify anyone. All right, well. In that case, got it, level 5. Am I at level 5 already? I thought this was level 4. It was killing with a pistol. There was killing with a pistol and steal the contents, and it was at the third level that added the extra target. I can still go about it this way, it'll just take a bit longer. Well, okay, that worked. That actually worked pretty damn well. Just have to be really on the ball. Five or six minutes for every level of this escalation. It's a pretty small map, so your options are always limited, and because you've got specific things to do anyway. But that final complication, it was almost like you knew that that's how I was going to do the previous thing. It's like it saw that I was doing a I pacified one of my targets and just left him there for later. I said, nope, you're not allowed to do that. You need to pee, sir. Would you like an armed escort, sir? OK. Okay, so that was level 5 of the... Yeah, alright. Training escalated. There's an achievement for that. Four minutes for that one. Alright, the only escalation remaining. Kitchen knife as yacht security. Get a lot to start this one, do you? I remember there being a disguise floating around. I just can't remember what that disguise was. Here it is. Got crew. Shit. Security. Where am I going to get a yacht security outfit? So, the guy that was in the kitchen was wearing a yacht crew outfit, but was not allowed to carry a kitchen knife. Yacht security, who has no real legitimate reason for carrying a kitchen knife, is allowed to carry a kitchen knife. There is yacht security, isn't he? Security cameras. Delete evidence within 2 minutes. Where the hell is the security console? Where? Nothing in there.
And a good day to you, sir.
Yeah. Fuck. Have I gone too far? I think I have. Yeah. Seem to be here. Except not here, here. Is that guy ever not there? Oh, bugger. Okay, they've got limited visibility. I see a fellow security guard running towards him with a brandishing a kitchen knife. Okay, the cameras can be avoided. And a security guard outfit is actually next to the yacht crew. That guy is yacht crew. Fine then. Why bother being careful? Can't be careful enough. Yeah, kitchen knife. Fuck. Always there. Didn't even hear the coin.
Yeah. Really?
Yes, really.
Huh. I'd like the sound of that. Great. Okay. All yacht security see through the yacht security and crew disguises. Oh, brilliant. Well. Okay. Before I tackle that, I need to pee. Be back in a minute.
Did do that. Yep. All right. Okay. There's a sudden urge to check I hadn't mislabeled my stream. So I just need to get around for a little bit in this disguise. Because they don't see through this one. Probably not allowed above decks in the thingamajigger disguise. But it's only the yacht security, and they were already pretty much enforcers for me anyway. Final level is what? Don't pacify anyone. Oh, within 5 minutes. Well, I've been doing that, so hopefully. Hopefully I can do it again. This outfit not being allowed upstairs is something of an assumption of mine, but one I'd rather not test on the final level of the thing. Bodies either. Certainly not terribly bothered about hiding dropped weapons. Now, can I actually just go out this way and distract him? Sort of. In 2 seconds. Alright, now that it's going to stop telling me about... Okay, it's telling me about contracts now. Although I'm certain I've not done every... Yeah, I haven't done that one. Don't know why it's not telling me about some of the other escalations it's got available. Thing to unlock the gun. Don't think I ever did an escalation at Bangkok. Yes, clearly at some point they decided that 3 levels of escalation was enough. I think I'm going to call it a night there. Managed to get this done. Not the best performance, but 47 needs to merge molecules with his targets before he can just hit them with a lead pipe. Otherwise, yeah, that was an interesting thing that they took 2 Season 1 elusive targets that were on the same map and merged them into one thing. He said, makes you wonder if they could manage to pull off something like that with, unless they were really going to be stepping on each other, how many times they could actually just put all of the elusive targets from a location active at the same time. There were a bunch at Sapienza, so I don't think they could do all of them at Sapienza, because some of them would surely end up crossing paths. But yeah, it was a bit of an interesting thing. I thought it was a new one until I saw it was Sapienza, then I thought there's no way that's a new one. Because if they were doing a new one, and there's still 2 Season 2 locations they haven't done an elusive target for, then that sucks. But yeah, just a reimagining of two season one Elusive targets. Anyway. Yeah, that's enough out of me for tonight. I'll get back to this again next week. Hopefully I'll come up with something to do. I should start doing contracts. Making my own, even. Where are the featured ones? There they are. We'll see. Otherwise, yeah, thanks for watching. I'll see everybody next time, whenever, for whatever. Bye for now.